this is Hercules. Right here. Now we're going to enter in here and take a tour of one of the rooms. This is the community. Here's the first room.
So there's two showroom rooms?
Yes, ma'am, yeah. Commonly asked question, are the rooms co-ed? The answer is no. No housing here at UCF is co-ed, but the floor is co-ed.
The way the dorm will look when you first move in, unfurnished, or you get the furniture but nothing else.
Important things to note is that the sinks in both of the rooms are very convenient, so if you do your hair, your makeup, anything in the morning, it is there, and then at the end of the hall, the bathroom.
This is what it looks like lived in. And that's the dorm room. Okay, this is the Libra community. You can see the different halls, those are the different dorm facilities. Bard Hall. Okay, this is Orange Hall, it's part of the Libra complex. And we're just gonna go inside here, take a quick look at one of the rooms. We won't be able to see the bathroom, just what the two rooms look like. It's a Jack and Jill style bathroom.
Behind me is going to be that sink area we were talking about earlier. It's very, very similar to what you told before, but if you guys want me to move out of the way, definitely can change that. Other things to note here about Libra, is they have some more storage above the area over here, and then there also is doors. Feel free to open them. Again, just more storage for the students. And what I was mentioning earlier with how everything's custom to you and based on availability, so if you wanted to choose the bed back in the corner, you can, or do you want to choose this one?
Now let's take a quick look at some of the other buildings. You have to have your card to get into any of these buildings. And once you go inside the building, then you have to have use your card to get on your hall. That's an entrance, that's Orange Hall. nice little courtyard here. Here's Seminole Hall. And there are a few common areas that everybody uses, such as the washer and dryers are all in the same area. I think you use your card for those also. Looks like this is where you park your bikes. Keep them out of the rain. And then they let you have a microwave and a small refrigerator in your room, but no cooking, no stove or anything. So there is one common kitchen with stoves and ovens that you can cook in. And then there's usually like a clubhouse or something that you can come to hang out in. So here we are in some of the freshman dorms. They do have a community activity center there. Nike. Okay, these are all freshman dorms in this area. Here's the laundry room. I believe these over here are called Neptune. And here's some more services. Mail, you'll have a key for your mailbox. You'll come pick it up if you have packages. You'll have to see somebody and show your ID and they'll get it for you. And other services available there. Here's a mail center. And there's where you can pick up the oversize. And it looks like you can drop mail off there too. We're gonna take a real quick look inside Northview. This is freshman and upperclass housing. It's just on the edge of the campus, so you wouldn't wanna walk, but there is a bus. Or of course you can drive or bike or anything like that. Most of the rooms here, you have your own bathroom, whether it's a 2-2, 4-4, however they design it. Each person usually has their own bathroom. We can't take a look inside any of the rooms today, but we'll show some of the amenities that are available on the first floor and the pool area. All right, let's go inside.
or it's not open. There is also an Amazon package hub located on campus. It's probably about a five to 10 minute walk from here, but it's probably just better to drive. So that's gonna be located on the north side of campus if you want. It's in here, there's pool tables, game consoles, little TV area, little kind of kitchenette bar back here that you can set up with your friends if you'd like. So this is an area to hang out. I don't see it used super often, but if it's definitely something that you can use if you'd like, as long as you have a need to, desire to use it, you absolutely can. One thing that's nice about our garage as well is that you can park on the floor that you live on and then go straight to your room. So if you live on, say, the fifth floor, you can just go straight to your room on the fifth floor. You don't have to go downstairs and then go up.